Hello, hello, all you beautiful people. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are making Breezy Peanut Butter Cup Cheesecake. It's actually a no-bake cheesecake. So what I did there was I put 35 Oreos in a bag and I am crushing them up. That's going to be the base or the crust of our cheesecake. Who doesn't love Oreos, right? Comment down below and let me know what your favorite flavor of Oreo is and what your favorite cheesecake is. So now I melted butter. I'm gonna put that in with the Oreos and mix it all up till it's kind of a wet sand consistency. To where, and just enough to where it holds together when you stick it in a pan. So I'm gonna dump it into the pan. And now it's time to squish. And notice Adele over there in the background. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna smash the crust and we're gonna go up the sides just a little bit. You don't have to go all the way up, just enough to kind of hold the cheesecake in. Now remember, we're doing a no bake here, so much, much easier. And she's back. She literally watches everything I do, so I'm sure you'll see her a lot in my videos. She cracks me up. Okay, once you're done, it should look something like this. And make sure that you spray the sides of your pan. Even though it has butter in it, you still just want to make sure that it doesn't stick, and I used a springform pan to make it come out easier. Now pop that bad boy in the refrigerator and let it hang out to chill until your filling is ready. Okay, y'all, now it's time for the filling. For the filling, we need 24 ounces of cream cheese at room temperature, or that's 3 8-ounce blocks. You're gonna add a half a cup of sugar to that. And you're going to mix it up until it's a smooth consistency. Next, you'll wanna add the vanilla, 1 teaspoon of that, and then creamy peanut butter, not the natural kind. You'll need 1 1/4 cups of the creamy peanut butter. Here, I am not really measuring out the peanut butter because most generally I don't measure. I just add in what I want, but in baking, a lot of the times I do measure because baking is a science after all. All right, make sure it's mixed until well combined. And then you're going to chop up some peanut butter cups and you'll want to add those into your filling. Mix until that's well combined also. And now the magical part happens. So this is what's going to make your cheesecake nice and creamy and fluffy. You're going to add in 1 1/4 cups of cold heavy whipping cream to a mixing bowl. Then you're going to add 3/4 cup of powdered sugar to that. Now don't do what I do here and leave your paddle in there. You're gonna want your, that's what you really want, your whisk attachment. So you're going to set your other stuff aside and you're gonna whisk this until stiff peaks form. Now usually it doesn't take that long. You'll want to turn your mixer on high and that'll be fine. But you don't want to over whip it because then you'll end up with butter. Now I could have used it like this, but I went a little bit longer just to make sure that it's as stiff as it needed to be. Without, like I said, without overdoing it because I didn't want butter. So now we're gonna fold it into the rest of the filling. So you'll wanna fold in half of it at first, and then once you get that all incorporated, then you'll fold in the other half until, yet again, it's well combined. Now you're ready to put it in the crust. You know, all the crust that you had in the refrigerator hanging out until you got the filling made? Yeah, that one. All right, so now we're going to put it in there. We're gonna now smooth it all out. You're gonna pat it down, smooth it out. I use a couple different tools here to smooth it and smash it around. I end up using this little gadget, which actually did a pretty phenomenal little job. And after you get all that smoothed out, it'll look something like this. Gorgeous, isn't it? Then after you get all that done, you'll want to put it in the refrigerator until you get the ganache made. So for the ganache, you will need 4 ounces, roughly 2/3 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips, and 5 tablespoons of heavy whipping cream. You will want to put your chocolate chips in a heat-proof bowl. Microwave the heavy whipping cream until it just begins to boil, then you'll pour it over your chocolate chips and allow it to sit for 2 to 3 minutes, and then you'll whisk until smooth. And then you'll get this gorgeous ganache that you'll pour right on top into an even layer, and then you top with more chopped greasy peanut butter cups. Bon appetito! And if you've made it this far, thank you. And don't forget, if you like this video, please consider subscribing if you're not already. Like the video and drop a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you.